Hi friends, let us continue with the concept of trophic level interactions. Now in this we have discussed about food chain and food web in the previous video. Now let us discuss the next concept in this interactions, which is ecological pyramids. Right now this ecological pyramids concept was developed by Charles Yelton. Right now this concept was developed by Charles Yelton. So that's why these pyramids are also called as Eltonian pyramids, right? Eltonian pyramids. These are also called Eltonian pyramids. Both are same. Now what this ecological pyramids exactly means, right? Now ecological pyramids are diagrams that illustrate how ecologically important factors such as your energy, biomass and population size vary between trophic levels in an ecosystem. Right now I will summarize the things here. Now ecological pyramids are diagrams that illustrate how ecologically important factors, ecologically important factors such as your energy. What are these ecologically important factors? Such as your energy, biomass, right? Now one more factor, population size. Population size. Right? Vary between trophic levels of an interaction. Now how these energy, biomass, population size vary between trophic levels of an ecosystem. Right, already we have discussed about the trophic levels in the previous video. Trophic levels of an ecosystem. Right. Now I will draw the basic diagram of ecological pyramids. Then I will discuss in detail regarding this. Right now see here, your ecological pyramid is nothing but a triangular shaped one. Right. Now first I will draw the diagram, then you can observe it. Right, the first trophic level is nothing but your primary producers. Right, primary producers. Right, your next trophic level is primary consumers. Right, and your next trophic level is secondary consumers. Right, now your next trophic level is tertiary consumers. Now see here, what this ecological pyramid exactly represent. Now the size of each portion of the trophic level illustrates the size of each trophic level in this ecological pyramid illustrates about the amount of energy or biomass or number of, I mean the population size found in each trophic levels. Now the size of each trophic levels in the ecological pyramid illustrates about the amount of energy, right? Now amount of biomass, or what you called it, other one, number of individuals, your population size, right? This is what we are drawing, this diagram in different sizes in each trophic level, right? Now you got the concept? Yes. Now this ecological pyramids are divided into three kinds. Now the first one is, already we have discussed this, based on this ecologically important factors, they are divided into three types. For the first one is pyramids of energy, and the next one is pyramids of numbers, right? And pyramids of biomass. These are the three types of pyramids that we have classified. Now we will discuss in detail regarding each pyramid. Now the first one to be discussed is pyramids of energy, right? First one is pyramids of energy. So I'm going slowly because this is very important concept. You have to focus on this. Pyramid of energy. Now what does this exactly means? Now already we have discussed in general. Now I will go into details. Now the pyramid of energy shows the amount of energy entering each level and varies across trophic levels. Now it shows that energy is maximum at its producer level and minimum at consumer level, right? Now I'll summarize this. See here what this pyramid of energy exactly depicts, right? It shows you the amount of energy, entering each trophic levels, right, across various levels. Means your primary consumers, secondary consumers and tertiary consumers across various levels, right? Now this is what exactly means. Now again, this pyramid of energy shows that energy is maximum at producer level and minimum at consumer level. Right? So I'll draw the diagram. See here, pyramid of energy. Right? Now, as we said, the energy is maximum at producer level, minimum at consumer level, the highest consumer level, right? Now see here, what are the producers? I'll write it as grass. Likewise your food chain, nothing but, right? Now the grass is taken by grasshopper, Now, the grasshopper is consumed by frog. Now, this frog is consumed by snake. Now, snake is consumed by hawk or your vulture, right? Tertiary consumer. Now, this is what your energy pyramid, right? Now, see here. I will explain again in detail. The consumers are at the top of the food pyramid. The consumers are at the top of the pyramid means they have less energy, right? They have less energy available to support them than those closer to the bottom. Now see here, these hawks will have less energy when compared to the trophic levels bottom to it. Yes, snake will have more energies. I mean, this trophic level support more energy than hawk, right? Now observe the difference between them. Now eventually the amount of useful energy left cannot support the another level, right? The amount of energy left in that level, the amount of energy left in that level, at that level, cannot support other level. Now, this is the prime point. Cannot support another level. Right? Now, that's why energy is depicted in the shape of a pyramid, right? That's why your energy will be declining down. Now, at every successive trophic level, there will be a loss of energy. Now, see here, there will be a loss of energy. Right? Now, this loss of energy will be in the form of heat and what? Respiration. Heat and respiration. Done. Now, the pyramid of energy is always upright and erect. Upright and erect. The next very important point what we discuss in pyramid of energy is Lindman's law. Lindman's law. Right, which is also called as 10% law. Now, what this Lindman's law exactly depicts? Now, this is very important for your examination. Focus on this. Right? Now, according to Raymond Lindman, what he says is, in an ecosystem, when energy is transferred from one trophic level to another trophic level, then 90% of the energy is used in maintenance of metabolic process, and only 10% energy is transferred from one trophic level to another trophic level. Now see here, I will write the definition in the next slide clearly. Now what 10% law says, or your Lindman's law says, observe here. In an ecosystem, I will write the exact definition here. In an ecosystem, when energy is transferred from one trophic level to another trophic level, when energy is transferred from one trophic level to another, one trophic level to another, right? 90% of the energy, 90% of the energy is used for मेंटेनेंस ऑफ मेटाबॉलिक प्रोसेस, मेंटेनेंस ऑफ मेटाबॉलिक प्रोसेस, मेंटेनेंस ऑफ मेटाबॉलिक प्रोसेस, राइट? नाउ एंड ओनली 10% ऑफ द एनर्जी इज ट्रांसफर्ड, 10% ऑफ द एनर्जी इज ट्रांसफर्ड टू द नेक्स्ट ट्रॉफिक लेवल, 10% ऑफ द एनर्जी इज ट्रांसफर्ड टू द नेक्स्ट ट्रॉफिक लेवल, राइट? आई लेट इट एज टीएल. दिस इज कॉल्ड योर लिंडमैन्स लॉ. नाउ what do you mean by this metabolic process? Now I think everybody knows about this. What about this metabolic process? This is nothing but usage of energy for digestion, am I right? Yes, usage of energy for digestion, for your respiration, for your respiration and your locomotion, right? I think you got clear this. This is called Lindman's law or 10% law. Now according to this, what happens? Now see here, I'll go to the back slide. Now when there is 10,000 kilocalories of energy in the producer level, now upon going to the next trophic level, how much of energy will be transferred? Only 10% of the energy will be transferred. Now how much of energy will be transferred? Only 1000 kilocalories of energy will be transferred. I've taken it an example, okay? Now going to the next level, how much of energy? 10%, so only 100 calories, I mean 100 kilocalories. Now for the next level, it will be 10 kilocalories. For the next level, it will be 1 kilocalorie. Exact depiction of your Lindman's 10% law. Right? Done. Focus on this. Now, let us go to the next concept in this. Now, the next concept what we deal in this ecological pyramids is ecological efficiency. Ecological efficiency. Now what this ecological efficiency exactly says, right? What does this mean? Now ecological efficiency refers to the percentage of energy transferred from one trophic level to another level, right? It refers to the percentage of energy, percentage of energy transferred from one trophic level to another, right? This is nothing but your ecological efficiency. Right. Now what are the characteristics of this, right? Let us speak about this. Now energy transfer from one trophic level to another trophic level varies from 5 to 35%. Now observe here, energy transfer varies from one trophic level to another trophic level at a range of 5 to 35%. Now for terrestrial ecosystems, what will be the energy transfer? For terrestrial ecosystems, the energy transfer, that I mean the rate of transfer, the rate of transfer will be 10%. Already we have discussed this with Lindman's law, okay? Rate of transfer will be 10%, right? Now whereas in marine ecosystems, how much will be the rate of transfer? it will be 20%. The rate of transfer of energy will be 20%. Now see here, when compared to this terrestrial ecosystems, marine ecosystem has more energy transfer and has more ecological efficiency. The kind of flora and fauna and the biodiversity it exists in marine is more. Now why in marine ecosystems there is more ecological efficiency? As we discuss here, due to rich biodiversity. And one more factor is, right, consumers don't move longer distance for their food intake in marine ecosystems. Longer distance for food intake, right? Now this is the prime point to be remembered in marine ecosystems. Therefore, when they don't move for longer distance, automatically for their metabolic process, they don't use much energy, right? Because am I right or wrong? Yes, they use less energy in this ecosystem. That's why marine ecosystem, the rate of energy transfer will be more, right? Now this is the point. Got the thing clearly? Yes. Focus on this. Now the next one is, already we have discussed energy of pyramids. Now we will discuss about pyramid of numbers. Now what this pyramid of numbers exactly says, right? Now pyramid of numbers shows the relationship between producers, herbivores and carnivores at successive trophic levels in terms of their number, right? Now pyramid of numbers shows relationship between producers, herbivores, right, carnivores at their successive trophic levels in terms of number of population, number of individuals living there, right? Now I will draw the pyramid of numbers here, right? Now see here, producers, herbivores, primary carnivores, secondary carnivores, right? Now I'll write like this: producers, right? So likewise I'll write it as plants again, right? So you can have a clarity of this. Plants, again I'll write the same example: grasshoppers. Now frog, snake, hawk. Okay, now by observing this, what we can say this, now this is nothing but terrestrial ecosystem, or you can call it as grass ecosystem. Grass ecosystem. Right. Now, let us discuss pyramid of numbers in terrestrial ecosystem or your grass ecosystem, right? Now, in grass ecosystem, the producers are mainly plants, right? Am I right or wrong? Yes. And always they are in maximum in number, so that's why I have drawn this larger way, right? Now, this number shows decrease towards apex as primary consumers are lesser than grasshoppers, yes, yes. And grass, this primary carnivores are lesser than this grasshoppers. Consequently, the secondary consumers are lesser than this. So automatically in grass ecosystem, the pyramid of numbers is upright, right? The population size will be decreasing in each trophic level. Now, let us discuss about one more ecosystem called marine ecosystem, or we generally call it as pond ecosystem, right? Pond ecosystem. This pyramid of numbers, you can have wide varied diversity. Now again, producers, what we speak as algae, phytoplankton, okay, now the next level will be herbivores, small fishes. Now the next one will be large fishes, carnivores, which eat on fishes. Now these fishes are eaten by, now see here, birds, right? Now this is pond ecosystem. Now also the pond ecosystem is also upright. That means what you can say, your producers are maximum in number, which are nothing but algae and phytoplankton. The herbivores are lesser in number, and the carnivores are lesser than this herbivores, and finally the top consumers are lesser than this secondary carnivores, right? Am I right or wrong? And the population size, the number of individuals decreases in each trophic level. There will be more herbivores, but there will be less, there will be more producers, but there will be less producers, and there will be less carnivores than this herbivores, right? Fine. In pond ecosystem, the pyramid of numbers is also upright. Now, the next pyramid of numbers will be parasitic food chain, right? Now, in parasitic food chain, now every year there will be one question on this, right? In parasitic food chain, the pyramid of numbers is inverted. The pyramid of numbers is inverted, right? Where can you find out inverted pyramid of numbers will be the question asked, right? Now in parasitic food chain, already we have discussed the pyramid of numbers are always inverted. This is because a single plant may support the growth of many herbivores. Now a single plant may support many herbivores, right? Likewise your birds, your parrot will be dependent on the mangoes and all the fruits of the tree, right? And again, each herbivore in turn may provide nutrition to many parasites, right? Likewise, your butterflies, right? Grasshoppers and all the things which eats on this, right? And these are called parasites. Now these parasites will give support to hyperparasites, right, which forms the top layer. Hyperparasites, done. Now thus, from the producers toward consumers, the number of organisms show an increment. Am I right or wrong? Thus making the pyramid inverted in shape. Now see here, hyperparasites, your decomposers will be large in number than this your parasites, likewise, which are dependent on birds, right? Butterflies, grasshoppers, flies, right? Now in parasitic food chain, the pyramid of numbers is inverted, right? Very important for your examination. Next, how it will be in a forest ecosystem, right? In forest ecosystem, now in forest ecosystem, the producers which are mainly large in size, in large size trees, are lesser in number, right? Are lesser in number, right? Now, and they form base of this pyramid. Large trees, right? Large trees. Now, the herbivores, which are normally birds, elephants, deer, etc., are more than the number of producers, right? Now see here, now this the herbivores, which are normally your birds, elephants, these are more number than this plants in the forest ecosystem. Therefore, again, thereafter, there will be a gradual decrease in number of successive carnivores, thus making the pyramid again upright. Now observe here, again your secondary carnivores will be lesser in numbers, right? Likewise, your hawks, vultures in forest ecosystem. Now this is the uniqueness of forest ecosystem. You will find large trees which are lesser in number, and again the primary herbivores will be in larger in number. And again, your secondary consumers will be lesser in number when compared to the herbivores, right? So this number, pyramid of numbers in forest ecosystem, is partly upright and partly inverted. Now this is the uniqueness, right? This will be the questions. You have to focus on this. Partly inverted. Done. Focus on this.